Recording here.
Sure.
And now we're up and running.
Matus, M-A-T-U-S.
And that will be on my Blackboard, and of course, we'll give you his contact information as well. So hopefully, everybody can get online because I think there's real value. He's going to give you a PowerPoint presentation first, and then we're going to do a live demo. This tool is one of the, he'll say it's the V tool, but it's one of the important tools that you should use as a real estate professional. And we know Charles will tell you that you use it all the time, right?
Every day.
That's what I wanted to hear.
Almost too much sometimes.
Oh, okay. Well, you can become dependent, you know, in an addict sort of way on these sorts of things. But the truth is, it's no different than having a pen and pencil or a slide rule. Remember what those used to be in your hands. All right, so I just want to make sure, can people actually open up your CoStar? So I see you got online, super. Let's see if anybody else can actually log into their CoStar right now. So I see Vitaly's in. How are you doing? Let's see if you can get in. Good. Monica, you're there. All right. Angelo is there. Dan, we'll give it a try. Hugh, did they answer the phone with you?
Yeah.
All right. Hopefully you're going to get there. Charles, you know you can do it. And Susan is here from the library world because she wants to learn about it as well. So she's going to be smart for everybody's benefit. All right, so almost all of you are getting there, which is great. All right, take it away, Daryl.
All right, thank you for the opportunity to present to you guys today. As Mark said, my name is Daryl Matus. I'm an account manager representative for the CoStar Group for about 4 years. Previously to working at CoStar, I was a multifamily agent at a little company called Marcus Millichap. So Marcus Millichap, was a company that I worked for from about 2003-2012 and was then, you know, I would like to say recruited to come over to CoStar when they acquired LoopNet. I'm assuming there's a range of you guys know a lot about CoStar, from Charles to a little bit about, you know, a little bit about CoStar. So I'm gonna, you know, explain to you the story of CoStar, where CoStar started, where CoStar is and where CoStar's headed, and effectively why it benefits you guys for in your studies, whether you're going to be a broker, whether you're going to be owner developer, whether you're going to be an investor, all types of companies use CoStar data. This is my business card, so if you guys have any questions after the presentation, want to email me, call me. I'm definitely available to answer any questions as well. So, what is CoStar? Who is CoStar? And why is it going to make your studies here easier and your professional life should you choose to go into your commercial real estate in one form or fashion? CoStar is the leading data provider of commercial real estate information. What that means is CoStar is a company based in Washington, D.C., and we have a lot of research hubs in Washington, Atlanta, Dallas, San Diego, all across the United States. We are a research company founded in the mid-80s by a gentleman by the name of Andy Florence. Throughout this whole presentation, it's a very similar story to how Facebook started. He somehow convinced the brokers and Washington, D.C., Baltimore area to share information. Used to be a book, then it was on a CD-ROM. Now it's on the internet as well as the iPad. And in about a month and a half, we're about to release an iPhone app too. So it's very powerful. It's a very powerful tool. CoStar, a publicly traded company since 1999. Roughly, there's about 3,000 employees that are worldwide. Last year, CoStar was named one of the 10 most innovative new companies by Forbes. We in aggregate, on all the websites that we run and all our visitors come to, there's about 22 million people that visit all our websites. So what are the websites that CoStar owns and runs? Well, CoStar, think of CoStar like a mothership. CoStar is a mothership, and under CoStar are a bunch of other companies, the most recognizable company being LoopNet. The short story about LoopNet, it's all public. If you guys want to go and Google Yahoo big, CoStar acquired LoopNet about 5 years ago. All in the acquisition was about $1 billion. So it was a huge acquisition, and LoopNet is the leading provider of market for listings. So if you're a broker, if you're an owner, and you're looking to list properties for sale or for lease, you're going to use LoopNet. 75% of the people that search LoopNet are non-paid members, such as tenants looking for spaces to lease, or a small investor, mid-sized investor looking for properties to buy. I like, in my presentations, demonstrations, my metaphor for LoopNet is think of LoopNet like a paid Craigslist for commercial real estate. That's what it is. CoStar is the Bloomberg terminal, if you will. It is the data. So it is where you, if you're doing a single tenant, if you're doing multifamily, anything commercial real estate, it's gonna have all the ownership data, it's gonna have the comps information, it's gonna have businesses that retract lease expirations, analytics. Also about 2 years ago, CoStar acquired Apartments.com. Apartments.com is the LoopNet for people looking for places to live. So there's been a huge initiative with CoStar over the last 2 years to make their multi-family data number one. CoStar's accomplished that. And then, below that are a lot of business websites. So CoStar has the number one business website called bizbysell.com, and then Rural Land, landsofamerica.com. So a lot of websites. Two most recognizable, one of them are obviously CoStar and LoopNet, which is where most people go. Again, this just reiterates what I said earlier. LoopNet is marketing. So as the marketplace evolves here, and I'm not sure how much you all track what's happening in commercial real estate, but over the last 5 years, there's been a lot of consolidation of real estate companies acquiring each other. Smaller companies are getting bought by bigger companies. So there's been a lot of consolidation within the real estate market. All these brokers and even owners, they go put their listings on LoopNet. So it's the most highly trafficked commercial real estate website in the world. If any of you go on Google, Yahoo, Bing, and type in for sale, for lease, retail, Florida, you're gonna see all CoStar LoopNet owned companies. And that's the millions of dollars that CoStar and LoopNet spend on what we call search engine optimization. So for all of you that are into that, search engine marketing, CoStar, as well as LoopNet, are number one in that. Again, CoStar is the information, is the most accurate database in the nation. CoStar, like any other company, has competitors. Obviously, it's great to have competitors because they keep us innovative. You make sure that we always are number one. But we like to call ourselves number one. Whether it makes us feel good or not, it's a whole different story.
Has anybody here used LoopNet? So, and it's really just as Daryl was saying, it's a marketing platform. So LoopNet uses data from CoStar, doesn't it?
Yeah. That's such a great point. So what happens is when a broker or an owner put a listing into LoopNet, it'll automatically filter it to CoStar. Now, the challenge with LoopNet, and this has always been a challenge, is that it's a user-entered system. So it used to be called the Wild Wild West LoopNet, because people would put stuff in there, and they could put an office building for sale in there, put it for a sale for $15 million. Nobody was doing any checks and balances. And it still goes on now, because it's all user-entered. CoStar's methodologies, they go in, they check and they verify that information is real. Unfortunately, in this business, whether you guys are brokers or owners, there's brokers that we're gonna deal with, or investors that are not telling the truth. That's why we have a thing called due diligence, and you get all the books and records, things of that nature. So all the listings from LoopNet going to CoStar, nothing of CoStar goes into LoopNet. So CoStar is the professional tool. LoopNet is the marketing service, if that makes sense. As far as the approach that CoStar takes. There's roughly now about 2,000 researchers. As far as data changes per day, there's a lot of data changes going in. And what that means is there's a lot of calls being made by researchers. They're making, whether there's a space that gets leased, a property gets sold, they're getting more information on an owner. These are the data changes that are getting done per day. It's a human interaction. The researchers, as Charles knows, are very well trained. Some of them, you know, will call you on your own time. They'll email you. It's their job to get real time data new to our clients. Is it perfect? Nothing's perfect. There's still erasers for pencils, but it's the best that's what's out there. CoStar also has cars out there. So before Google, ever came out with their cars, CoStar had their field research vehicles out there. So there's three here in South Florida, and they literally drive the market. They take pictures of for lease signs, for rent signs. They're doing daily sign checks. They're going to office buildings, taking pictures of legends. So there's a huge thing going on where they have their own metrics that they have to meet to get data that transfers back to corporate, which in turn, gets it to our clients faster, more efficiently. All high resolution pictures in CoStar, whether it's a Class A office building, LEED certified energy efficient, or a little small, your mom and pop 8-unit C-class building that's here in Fort Lauderdale. We have all different types of pictures. There's various ways we get the pictures. The brokers provide them to us, our field research vehicle, people take them. We take them as field people out there. There's all different ways. We do pull them off LoopNet sometimes as well, if the broker wants us to. So there's various ways that we get the pictures. One thing that's very important is, as you all probably know, a lot of publicly traded companies own real estate. So they got to provide their data. Our researchers go on the courthouse filings, on the public records, on third-party data feeds. They're going into websites that are just far and beyond that people like us don't have the time to. So they're really digging in. I like to call it web robots. That's my fancy word. But the real thing is what they're doing is they're scrubbing websites. So when CBRE or JLL or whoever it is has listings, a lot of them don't update their websites that often. So we're actually going into the websites, making sure their listings are real. So and you will never see listings on all the main shops' websites before they've been shopped around internally. But a lot of those listings are already on CoStar. So CoStar is the professional tool. If you're in a real situation, if you're a CBRE broker or Marcus Millichap, wherever, if you get a call from a residential broker that says, I got a buyer that wants to buy a $50 million asset, probably not the buyer. I'm not saying it's not going to happen. South Florida has crazy things that happen, but you really research who you're talking to, and CoStar lets you do that. We also track the top 2,000 retailers. So whether it's Publix, Walgreens, CVS, if you want to know how far Jimmy John's is from a Five Guys, CoStar tracks that for you. We also have demographic data. We also have traffic counts. So it's a one-stop shop, CoStar. It also brings in public record as well. So this is your one-stop shop for commercial real estate. That is what CoStar really is. Last year we bought a plane. Why did we buy the plane? Don't know, it cost a lot of money. But
how much?
I wasn't privy to that, but I was asked to go on the plane, and since I had no bathroom, I said I'm not going in the plane. It's actually too small for me. I can't fit in that. But the plane, the whole purpose of the plane was our CEO wanted to fly over dirt to make sure that the dirt wasn't getting pushed. So it literally flies over all major cities to make sure that multifamily development, office development, retail, et cetera, it's actually coming out of the ground. And Most importantly, again, to our clients, it's getting the data to them quicker and faster because we're literally flying over these sites. So now you take into account the driving as well as the flying, it's a fraction of the time that we get the data to you so that you can do what you need to do with the data.
I have a question. Is CoStar privately owned?
No, it's a publicly traded company.
It is, okay.
Yeah.
Fine, thank you. And the time that, so a Google Aerial or any of these, Nat Geo or any of these other aerials, what is their actual time from when the photo comes
from
the satellite to market?
Yeah, so for now, and I think it's changing over, CoStar uses Bing Maps. So it's whenever Bing flies over the site. So we have some that flew over a month ago, some that flew over 6 months ago. I believe we're switching over to Google soon, but for now we're using Bing Maps. So it's that there might be a delay sometimes. And that's another reason why we bought the plane too, because as you can see, right below, this is a military grade, so it actually takes the picture. So it's gonna then override whatever Bing has. So, hopefully that kind of answers your question.
So it's computer guided and actually can snap it. So for those very active development sites, it will actually help update to the latest.
Yeah, it's huge. It's huge for developers. One thing that a lot of people don't know, CoStar tracks full life cycle. So it's gonna track a property when it's proposed all the way to when it's demolished. So CoStar is aware of properties, which I'll show to you shortly, of multifamily properties that have been proposed for delivery in, say, 2017. So it's tracking everything. Our researchers are literally going to websites of different municipalities and seeing what's going on with the documents. And as well as we work with our brokers too. They have specific projects that they're working on, specific needs. We also have people here on the ground that full-time do workshops, tutorials, that they will get into it further with you. So there's a lot of cool stuff at CoStar that some people are aware of, some people aren't aware of.
Do they use drones as well? Or is that the only
thing? So yeah, I don't know the whole legal aspect of drones. I know there's a legal reason why we're not using drones. I don't know the exact answer to it. I'm sure once that becomes legal, CoStar is going to be able to use drones. Hopefully this video will play for you guys, because this is our CEO speaking, and then we'll go live with the product. Yeah, get this going here. Make this louder, I'm sorry, it's not loud enough.
Do you need sound?
Yeah.
Could you have to take that little plug that's next to the DGA and plug that into your soundboard?
I'll talk over it. This is what we do. I mean, these are researchers making phone calls. This is our CEO. This is literally our people driving down the street, and they know what's going on. You're gonna see our researcher, you make a phone call right here, and this is the calls that people like Charles get, other people get. They pull the listings off of LoopNet. All commercial real estate. So anything commercial real estate.
So where are these people primarily located? In DC?
Yeah, so they're primarily located in Washington, DC, in Atlanta, San Diego, as well as Dallas. What's amazing about CoStar is this gentleman, Andy Florence, started CoStar in his Princeton dorm room, and it's very similar to Facebook. He had a friend, they somehow got some angel money, and they started sharing information with the brokers. They built a book. There's a company by the name of Black Sky up in New York that CoStar acquired in the late 90s, and then in the year 2000, CoStar acquired a company out of San Diego called Comps.com. And so it kind of started to grow and went to a CD-ROM, and then it was on a book, and then obviously technology exploded. So it's a very powerful tool because it's at your fingertips. So it's never going to replace what you know locally as an owner or as a broker or things of that nature, but it's going to supplement and it's going to make your time that much more valuable. I mean, this is a huge supplemental tool to your knowledge. As far as what CoStar is really most proud of, is really two things, is that last year, 2015, 86% of commercial real estate transactions happened with a CoStar user. So it's a huge market that we have. Whether you're an owner or a broker, whatnot, you are a user of CoStar. It's a very powerful tool. Whether it's office, this is US right here. CoStar tracks it all. New multifamily, land, industrial, retail. These are sampling of some of our customers. So again, as I mentioned, whether you're a broker, whether you're a retailer, whether you're an owner, I think we recently signed up Five Guys, Subway, all different companies use CoStar data for all different wants and needs. And most importantly, it's got a 94% renewal rate. So once this tool goes in your hands, whether it's your own new single entity company, or you guys decide to join a firm, you're gonna make money with this tool. It's a very powerful tool. So, lo and behold, this is CoStar. So, I'm gonna assume none of you have used CoStar before, and kind
that's
of-
That's a good assumption, except for this one guy over here.
Except for this one guy right here. So, this is CoStar. Obviously, you gotta have a subscription to log into it. I'm not an attorney, never wanna play attorney, but I will tell you guys, do not play funny games with CoStar's data. There's a lot of companies that like to do some funky stuff with CoStar that end up getting caught, and it's not good. So just whether you guys are at school here or if you decide to go on to work for a company, just use it for your own business purposes. CoStar, it's made up of three modules, CoStar. Property, comps, tenant. All these modules right here have all different wants and needs. This right here is gonna track all the information for ownership data, lease information, things of that nature. So a simple search in CoStar, would be to say, okay, let's go look at every single office building or retail building that's in a certain area. You can literally click on all properties right here. And then what you're gonna see is you're gonna see a map. This map's gonna pop up and it's gonna show you your where, and it's gonna show you your what. So there's all different things going on right here. There's blue icons, there's gray icons. What this basically means is CoStar is tracking everything. It's full of senses. It tracks for lease, for sale, not for sale, not for lease. So as a rule of thumb, our researchers are speaking to every owner, broker, property manager every 30 days. So this property may have nothing available, but we're still tracking all the ownership data. These properties that are blue have something available, whether it's for lease or the property is for sale. As far as looking now at deeper about the property, this is where CoStar becomes a very valuable tool. If you want to look at a property and say, okay, show me all the information on this particular property, what's going on with the leasing information, who owns it? If we literally go right here, we can put an aerial shot on. Okay, and now you're looking at this property right here, and it's gonna give you a little snapshot. This is the property right here. This is an office building. Nothing is, it's not for sale right now, but let's look at all the details. And this is where
Daryl, let me interrupt you. Let's all go to that same property.
Yeah, sure.
Because it's hard to read up on the screen.
Yeah, sure. So
it can go together.
Yeah.
Especially your property, I think that would be beneficial. So
Yeah, so it's 550. Yeah, it's 550 West Cypress Creek Road. And it'll populate for you guys. So for people like me that have fat fingers that misspell stuff, it'll populate for you.
You want to go to all properties first?
Yes. Yeah, and then in that location bar, type in 550 West Cypress.
Right, the CoStar is generally smart enough to know what's located where, which is really interesting. Alright, so everybody should have 550 West Cypress Creek Road, and it will say building number 2. Right, folks?
Now why this is important is for many reasons, but just to kind of show you guys, there's all these tabs up here. There's 12 tabs. There's a summary tab right here. This tab recently but about 9 months ago, this summary tab came out. And basically, it summarizes all these other tabs right here. And what's cool about CoStar is it's very interactive. So anything that's a line or that lights up is a link. So this is a summary of this particular property, 550 West Cypress Creek Road. It's based in the Cypress Creek market. It's 110,000 Class A office building, and it's got 30,000 square feet available for lease. So right here is all your summary information. So if you're on the phone with an investor or doing your own due diligence research, if it's a comp for you, you literally are seeing this information live, and it's going to give you a summary of when it last sold, all the building data. And this will start becoming secondhand nature for you, because you'll see this layout in every single property. Now, for all the different property types, it's a little different, but this is what it is. Land information, tenants that CoStar is aware of that are in the building. So these are businesses that we're tracking. This is very tough information to get, tenant information. Brokers aren't just willing to give out, or owners, who their tenants are, what their leases are. CoStar gets it. We have a dedicated tenant research team. We got amenities information, as well as building notes, location information, and then right in the bottom right, you see traffic counts. So we use a company called Data Metrics. So this is more important for office and retail, but there's your traffic counts, and it geocodes it right from the building. And we can dig in further to all the different data. There's your demographics, there's your assessments, which is your public record, and then here's your marketing flyers. So these are the marketing flyers that the broker has provided. So this is your marketing flyer on the building. So it's there for you, it makes it very easy. It's called the Pinnacle Park Corporate Office Building, and all the different new marketing flyer, new information that Avison Young has. Shows you who new the broker is. There's also a press release. So brokers do a lot of press releases, and it's great. It's great. It's great publicity. We sold the building for X. This is how we sold it. So we keep a running tab of press releases. So this is going to build your market knowledge, because obviously when you guys are talking about deals, you want to know who did the deal, how it sold, why it sold. So CoStar is going to paint a picture. We're going to get all this information for you. It's gonna be nice reading material, but it's important to know why these buildings are selling. Property contacts. So this now becomes your lead generation. If you're looking at calm market conditions, and then what's very cool about CoStar, think of yourself like Superman or like Wonder Woman. Now you're gonna have X-ray vision. Let's get inside the building. Let's see what's going on. This is everything that is for lease or that's been leased out. So if you really want to get in the data, okay, now what you're seeing is you're seeing every single space inside this nice office building that's for lease. What you're going to see is it the direct, is it a sublet space? CoStar is the only company in the world that tracks relet and sublet, meaning if we went to this building, we would only see Avison Young sign. A lot of times you have brokers that are subletting a space for a tenant, and CoStar will track that for you. And it's funny, sometimes I do demonstrations for clients of mine, and we go to a building of theirs, and they're not even aware that there's a sublet space, for lease. It's a huge office building, there's a lot of spaces. So this is very powerful to track your own properties. What's very important about this is it tells you what the suite number is. This is the information, floor plans, these are the documents. If you even want to go in further to it, it's going to tell you how long this space has been in the market. Now, why is this important? It tells you all the information right here. It's triple net. This is your rent per month. This number is important because in CoStar, that number is like a stock ticker. It's when it first hit the market. What happens in LoopNet is a lot of times brokers put properties on the market, they take it off, they fix it up, they do a price reduction, and that number restarts again. This is like your stock ticker. It's always going to tick, and it's very important for a tenant rep broker to know how long the space is available in the market. And then here's your marketing flyer again. Here's all your information on the listing contacts. So Peyton, Greg, those are your listing brokers. So if you had a tenant looking for this type of space, these are the guys to call. So it's very cool. If you guys haven't heard about Avis & Young, they're one of those companies that have come into the market over the last 5-10 years and made a nice foothold, purchased a couple of companies, and do a lot of leasing as well as investment sales. And what's important about that is, again, CoStar is total transparency. Whether it's me, whether it's Mark, whether it's Charles, whether it's you, CoStar tracks everybody. So if you want to know anything about Addison Young or Greg Martin, you can literally click on this. It's going to tell you everything about this particular Addison Young office, who they are, what they do, their top clients, their top deals. I'm sure you've seen this, right? So this is very powerful because it gives you email addresses, it gives you phone numbers, and this is huge right here. I can tell you guys that when I was a broker at Morgan Smith & Chapman, I kind of knew about this, but I really never delved into it. And when I went to go work for CoStar, I went through a month training up in Washington, D.C., and when I saw this, I was baffled because it shows you, this is basically giving you who the contacts are. And this is huge for owners, too.
Yeah, I was about to say that I use it for owners more than you.
Yeah, and so this is huge because a lot of owners also do their own leasing and have their own companies. So this will tell you properties that they are leasing out, properties that they're a broker on. This will give you a snapshot of transactions they're doing. So this is very important. So whether it's a broker, whether it's an owner, whoever, you can go to CoStar and type it in. It's very cool stuff right here. Also, CoStar tracks sale comps. Again, we've been tracking sales in South Florida since 1999. So in South Florida, as long as, maybe 1998, but you're gonna see the history of the sale of the property. So again, if you're on the phone and you're talking about this property, you wanna know, just know for your own market knowledge, this is when the property last sold. And this is the verified research that our researchers are doing. So this is the buyer, your buyers, bought it, based in New York, phone number, website, Brett Gottlieb, there's his email address, and that's your seller. Obviously, don't need to tell you, both these companies are leads, because a lot of sellers own real estate. They could be dispositioning it for all different reasons. They want to move into a different product, different market. They bought the product at Y, their exit strategy was X. So all these people are leads. And the very cool thing about CoStar is it kind of shows you how active they are. So this is how active this particular company is. And then we'll start getting to the details of the actual comp, what the actual comp was sold for. So it was sold for $38 million. That's your price per square foot. This was the cap rate at the deal, and this is how long it was on the market for. And again, this is all research. And then you're probably going to ask me, well, how the hell does CoStar know all this? Okay. Well, this is also the loan, too. So this is public knowledge. Once the loan gets reported, it's public, but we bring the loan information. this happened to be a deal that was near both buildings side by side. So it was a 500 building, as well as a 550 building. So you've seen it was a two office acquisition. And then the most important thing, it's all important, but most important thing is also the sale notes. This is what our researcher did. It shows you how we verified it. So it was sold to Northwest Mutual Company. This is why I sold it. It was a joint venture. There's your brokers right there. There's your loan, deed, press release. So it's all there for you. And then if you really want to know who did the research, this is the researcher. Which part of subscribing to CoStar, which is very important, is CoStar's researchers, they're there. They're making a lot of phone calls, doing a lot of research. They are your researchers. They want to hear from you and get feedback if there's something missing, if you need more information. They want you to make money from CoStar, as do we. And then this is how we verified it. So we spoke to the buyer, we spoke to the listing broker, we did a doc inspection, and we really got deep into it. So this is not just going on public record and seeing 123 LLC, you bought it. This is really piercing the corporate veil, showing you how the acquisition was done, why it was done. And then obviously, if you know the brokers or wanted to get any more questions answered, they're definitely available to you. There's demographic data, as I mentioned. So if you want to know the demographic data, it's all there for you. If you want to do 1, 3, 5 miles out, if you want to do population, if you want to do daytime employment, it's all there for you. Public record, not that you can't have public record up, whether it's the Dade County site, Broward County site, the CoStar just brings in public record, makes it very easy for you. And then the contact, which is really the first thing I should have showed you, but this is all the players involved with this property. Leasing company, sublet company. This is the recorded owner. So this is what you're gonna see in the actual tax records. And then when you actually pierce the veil, this is the guy to call. So you had a deal that was similar to what this company owns. And you know, as we did the search before, you said, okay, who's it? You know, what is DRA, advisors? Tell you who they are, properties they own. And what you're gonna see in CoStar is, a lot of times, what you're gonna see, is these companies own properties nationwide, and they own different types of assets. It's not just office, it's not just retail. A lot of times, they do own, one-off, like it looks like, they own a multifamily asset in, Minneapolis. But you're really gonna see what type of properties they own. And so it's a warm call. It's not a cold call. You know, the worst thing you can do if you're doing brokerage or just making phone calls to people is to not know what a company does. You have to do the research ahead of time. It's very important. And then you also have to know what transactions they're doing. The last thing you want to do is call an acquisitions person like Brett if you have a deal for him or you don't want to discuss and say, Brett, whether you work for a company, you want to know what they're doing, what they're selling, what they're buying. Are they doing dispositions, acquisitions? So you really want to get in deep and have that phone call. If you're going to shoot an email and then make the phone call, you really got to you make it stand out. So it's very important. A lot of these brokers, as you can see, their last deal was right before the New Year. It was like Marcus Smolchek did the deal. These guys have a lot of listings, so they're marketing themselves. So it's very important to know who these companies are. Images, as I mentioned, we have an image gallery. It's all here for you guys. If you want to use the pictures as part of your business, part of your presentations, it's all here for you guys. We also have a map function, which I'll get into a little further. The comps are one of the most important aspects of CoStars. And there's two types of comps in CoStar. There are sales comps, which is what your investment brokers use, and then there's your lease comps. which is really what your landlord reps and your tenant reps use the most. So there's your two type of comps. So as far as lease comps, if we just show lease comps real quick. This is spaces that have been leased out or that are about to expire. And this is powerful because if you are a retail landlord rep, if you are a retail tenant rep, you have your market knowledge of what's going on, but you also want to know, what does CoStar know about certain tenants that leases are expiring? So we can literally plug it in and plug in any particular area, say, okay, in Fort Lauderdale.
We can't.
What's your question, Angela?
Sorry, you don't subscribe to the lease comps.
Okay, so we'll skip lease comps for now.
Yeah.
We'll find out about that another time. Does sales comps work for you guys?
Let me see.
But I thought lease comps are supposed to work.
First. Should work.
All right, so will you just help me to open that up, please?
Sales comps doesn't work for you guys?
Yeah,
sales comps. Sales comps work. Okay, so let's go to sales comps. Let me get a note about lease comps. Okay, so let's talk about sales comps. This is great stuff. So this is if you guys are doing if you're doing a broker opinion of value, if you want to know the comps in the market, this is very powerful. So, you know, we'll basically use Fort Lauderdale as our example. Now notice that.
Hold on, did you click on property or comps?
Comps.
Okay, great.
Now it's hard for you guys to see right here, but you can draw on CoStar. You can go to a certain area, you can zip code it out. So if you really want to zero in on a certain area, you can search in CoStar any way you want. But just for our purposes, just to make it quicker and more efficient, you know, if I take to Fort Lauderdale, so here's Fort Lauderdale right here. And let's just use multifamily. Now notice, this is everything in Fort Lauderdale that CoStar is tracking. If I press multifamily, and I do every deal that's sold, say in the last 2 years, sold, we'll do 1/1/2015. So it's gonna be the Fort Lauderdale metro area. There's been, see the top right there? Run the top right, it says 281 records. What that means is there's been 281 comps done of multifamily in the last year. Now, what are these comps? And if you press view results, let me find my little, these are your research verified comps. Now, there's a lot of reports in CoStar too. You can print these out and have them as one page, as a three page one, but you can really get in the comps and see the comps and see what deals done. And you can sort on it by price, by sales day, by area, by buyer, and if we sort by sales date, these are your most recent deals that have been done. And what's important about our sales comps is our sales comps, a lot of the times, you actually see these comps before they ever hit the tax records. The tax records generally take 30, 45 days. You're gonna see these comps before they ever hit the tax records. And CoStar will tell you, you know, why they're researching the sales comps. Like, here's a deal that just got done right here on 12/15, and it's going to show you, are we still researching it? Who's the buyer? Who's the seller? So this was a deal, a portfolio deal. Let the internet catch up here. And there's your buyer. So this is just, these are, if you look at the property right there, it looks like a BC property. This is, the, you know, this is a BC multifamily property. Notice where the seller comes from. The seller comes from Canada. That's a Canadian phone number. Okay, and this is not your type of seller that owns tons of property. We can, you know, do some further research, but this is your buyer. The buyer is in Miami Beach. So, you know, out of state, you know, buyer, cashing out, local buyer that's buying the property, and this is what they bought right here. And again, it shows you all the different research, all the actual comps. Now, from a prospecting perspective, if you wanted to see all the buyers and kind of summarize it, say, okay, who are all the buyers? Up at the top right here, the tab that says companies. So if you click on that tab right here, what this does right here, it actually takes each sale and it'll show you who the buyer is, a lead, who the seller is, a lead, and it'll summarize who they all are, what deals they own, what deals they've done, websites, phone numbers, anything you can imagine, all here for you guys. It's right there in front of you. This is the millions and millions of dollars of CoStar research that and phone calls that we're making. So we can only scroll down, look at this particular buyer, you know, who's the buyer, he owns 12 properties, this past year did 2 deals, and this is who he is. If you guys want to know the most active brokers, this is the most active brokers. These are the brokers doing the deals. Kai's, Capital Commercial, Marks Millichap, JOL. These are your brokers. So you can literally start doing research on all these different brokers as well. So whether you're an investor, whether you're a broker. Now, what's very cool about CoStar 2 is you can do analytics. So if you want to know market performance, how is the market performing? What's going on with the market? Inside CoStar Properties, called analytics right here, we can analyze the actual market. So for our purposes, let's just analyze office. So if you want to do retail. So if we do property, and since we're in Broward County, let's do Broward County. So if we go into property, now this is what's very cool about CoStar before I go into a little further. If we're just looking at Broward County by itself, CoStar is tracking 29,000 commercial properties in total, all commercial real estate, medical office, retail, you name it, churches, synagogues, pet motels. It's tracking it all. So this is everything that CoStar is tracking. If you want to go to just to show you in South Florida, this is the Tri-County market. And it lights it up for you, so it shows you what it's actually looking at. So it's tracking, in South Florida, we're tracking 85,000 commercial properties. And then you can start drilling down. I just want to look at office.
So I want you to go back again to make sure that, because I'm making sure that I get it right.
Yeah, sure.
So go back to the homepage, if you will.
Absolutely.
Because I think this is important. People understand this is really your market analytics. So back to your analytics, and which one did you click the tab on?
So right here, property analytics, right? This top one right here.
You start on property analytics, and then in location, you actually type in just the word Broward.
I think for CoStar, I think it's Broward.
So for example, here when I type it in, it's forcing me to do outline Broward County submarket. Yeah. So how do you get the entire Broward
County? Yeah, type in Broward County, comma, Florida.
I see.
It's a little bit of a smart system, CoStar, outsmarts itself.
All right, there you go.
But luckily, I'm here to try outsmart.
Well, and so I'm just trying to see, so folks, sometimes you have to use a couple of clues here, and then finally it gives you all 20,627.
But then also on the left-hand side, it's got the county tab. You can't see it up there.
Yes, yeah, exactly right. Charles is right. So right in the left-hand side, it says county too.
That's right. You can
click on that and just you move the caret over to Broward County.
So you have all those little off-between. So you can use a polygon, a radius, a corridor, the zip code, the submarket, the city, the county, and you can actually zoom in, folks, on any one. And then, of course, you can click on the right-hand side, your property type, and then zoom in. And so you have the ability in any of the 3 South Florida counties to do this. We haven't given you the ability to go nationwide. Daryl can go nationwide. I can go nationwide as an academic to do that. So that's really, I think, very important to do that. But something else, and I just want to jump ahead, if you all go back to the home screen, and what's really beneficial too is underneath that, if you look at the market reports, if you want to just get an understanding of the market reports themselves, you'll see that underneath property and comps analytics, if you click on market reports, it will actually pop up with a little box, and they'll give you the ability to, for any number of cities across the country, or any number of markets, to give you industrial, office, retail, not multifamily. They just don't do multifamily yet.
I know that either.
Yeah, land, yeah, I mean
they're not
we track land, but we don't, you bring a report, so.
They're not there yet. So yeah. that's a great summary report to start, and then you can dig down. I'm just giving you a process,
yeah.
A way to approach it. Yes, Charles.
What is the market reports for? Because I've never used it.
Yeah, so these are the quarterly market reports that our researchers come out with. Basically, if we just use Broward County, you know, office, for instance.
It's a narrative.
Yeah, exactly. It's a narrative, and then it highlights the bigger deals that have come out. So a lot of our clients love to read this, you know, see what's going on. They will use this as part of their work. Obviously, they reference CoStar and whoever else they're using as this. But as Mark mentioned, there's a narrative right here. So this was the fourth quarter Broward County office market that came out. So it's good. A lot of our clients use this as a quarterly newsletter, so to speak.
So if it's something relevant, I'm assuming you can use it for like an OM or something?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. And then, as long as you reference that it came from CoStar or things of that nature, then it's all good. But for your edification, if you are a numbers junkie, and this data comes from inside the CoStar live data, you can start seeing where the market was back in 99, where it was at the worst, even when the world was coming to an end, back in 09, 08, where it is now. And you can really start getting deep into this. And it'll track submarkets, absorption, and these reports are the live data that are in actually right here. So if you go to Property Analytics, and we
What's the margin of error? Because obviously you guys don't have 100% of everything. So what's the percentage that's missing in extreme cases?
You're talking about missed data?
Well, I mean, is there anything? Yeah, because not everybody uses CoStar, right?
Sure.
So
that's,
I mean,
right.
No.
Right.
So is it,
yeah,
possible,
so you're right,
that you're missing data that could trip the...
It's possible. Yeah, it's definitely possible. Now, CoStar's got many clients that... Well, I should say, CoStar's got many people that don't subscribe to CoStar, but have their data on CoStar. So if that makes sense to you guys. So there's a lot of brokers that, you know, are old school, that have done it a certain way for a long period of time, and God bless them, they're very successful. I think Pat Montebello, very successful, her shop here locally. She loves using LoopNet. And we thank her for her business because she's in turn using one of our subsidiaries. Eventually, one day, we believe we'll get her to use CoStar. But she, you know, that's the way. So, but she's still providing her data to CoStar. So, whatever leases, I'm just using that company as an example. They are, but yeah, there are going to be some brokers that are not going to take the phone call or not. But if we look at it, and a lot of times I do this with an office broker or a retail broker that's in the market, and I show it to them. I say, okay, tell me about Fort Lauderdale. Does our data, and I don't go the whole market, because there's a lot of brokers that specifically focus on, say, AB. And I say, okay, is this what you would perceive? So we're going to analyze 395 properties in Broward County, in Fort Lauderdale. So, in this market, and a lot of times you withdraw the area of where they are doing most of their business. But for our purposes, this is about efficiency and effectiveness. And it's about saying, okay, once everything catches up here, what you're going to see is charts and graphs. So you're going to see charts and graphs about what CoStar is actually doing. It's going to summarize it all.
So our objective here is giving you a tool. There are other providers like Reese, Real Capital Analytics, local providers like Critics that can do a very good job. This is one tool, and if you only relied on this one tool, you wouldn't be a very good professional. you combine this with other resources.
Yeah. I mean, there's you know, RealCap is a good comps service. You know, Pierce Allison is good too. Obviously, CoStar, you know, we think we're better within the best, but that's for our clients to decide. I mean, that's the renewal rate that we put, you know, pop up every year. So it's really your beauty's in the eye of a beholder, you so to speak.
So let's go back to that homepage. Differentiate for us, or tell us the difference between the property analytic and the comps analytic. Once again, we're under the analytics, the orange word there on the homepage. If you go back to the homepage. And I'm trying to help the students here understand how they can use the resource, because they're going to use this tool for their homework assignment for this next week, for the project that Jessica Scully is going to be, Styles is going to be bringing to us. So let's see if you go back to and get rid of that man.
Yeah.
All right, we'll get back to CoStar. Thank you. And also, I'm going to ask you to help explain your star or your rating system, because
yes,
that's beneficial,
yeah,
as well, to help people understand, because every source has a different way of ranking real estate, and the difference is important to know as well. All right,
so
we're almost there. So there you have, under analytics, you have property and then comps. Help us understand the distinction.
Yeah, sure. So property analytics, we're analyzing all the properties. So we're analyzing everything. So you know what I mean by that is, again, this is hopefully it works this time. If we just set office and we just pick Fort Lauderdale, this is going to analyze every single building. So whether it's for sale, not for sale, for lease, not for lease. So we go to view results, and this is not going to be all types of office buildings, A, B, C, F, you name it. So we can zero in on a certain type. It's going to do some stuff right here. But eventually, it will get there. If not,
and by the way, so it says 1,667 properties and then 1,003 spaces. That's not referring to.
Yeah. So within those properties. So yeah, within this 1,600 properties, there's 1,000 spaces for lease. So, and once it catches up here, what you're going to see is there's all these tabs right here. There's the actual properties, there's the actual spaces, and then this again changes, you reach the velocity. And this is important, which I don't know if it catches up here for you guys, because it's really going to show you the analytics as well as the velocity, what's happening within the market. I'm not sure what's going on.
Your computer is much slower than the rest of our computers, because we're all there already. And we have a great snapshot summary here.
What
rates,
we jump on your internet.
That's
I think
right. Everybody else has it on their screen, right, folks?
Yeah,
pretty much, right?
Which is your internet? This one right here?
Yes.
We've got the summary, availability, 5-year average rate.
Which
is?
Yes,
right here? Oh, yes.
Yeah, guest is the right one. Thank you. And not NSU. Yes.
Now we're zooming.
They do that to fool you.
Now we're zooming.
Susan, who is the NSU Wi-Fi for? It must be for some secret cabal.
I don't know.
That's right.
It's an OI.
We're being recorded too, Daryl.
Oh, that's great. Don't send this to my boss.
That's right. Let's see if this speeds you up just a bit. But folks, what this does is actually shows you trends, and I use this actually a lot because I think it does give you a great overview. And so while the reports are really helpful, it's a military friendly school, I'm just looking at the ads up here.
That's us.
Yeah, you know, one of the things CoStar does do is ads too, so
yeah.
That's nothing for you guys
to
worry about.
I guess we're not paying your dollars.
No,
we're not. We're very fortunate they give us to the school complimentary, which is wonderful.
Love it.
Which is really super. So it's a real great benefit, because they're going to convert you all into wonderful users too at some point.
That's right.
Yes. Okay. Here we go. It's going to come up pretty sure right now. I'm hoping. It's in the password seat there. And also, as everybody's looking at their page there, when it has charts, and they just simply have a list of just about every single chart there. And so the beauty of this is that you can rebound this for office, and then you can click this for retail for any other number of uses here. So I'm waiting. I'm just trying to fill in for Dale. So.
Yeah, no, I mean, you know, I don't respond to that computer for somewhere.
Okay. And what's also interesting, everybody, if you click, you'll notice next to the on the upper right hand corner of your chart, to 1, 3, 5, and 10 year. And it helps you when you click on the 10 year, you get a real good sense of what's going on there.
I know.
So,
say, guys, you know, if something happens with your account, meaning if it doesn't work, just have technical support's phone number on you, programmed in your phone, because they are very helpful. And it will happen from time to time where for some reason it won't work, or maybe you bought a new computer, just something happened. So just I'll show you where to find that phone number, but
yeah,
it's
they hide
important.
It very well. Alright, here, let's see if we got it.
They do the ranking.
I hope. Finally.
Yeah, they do.
Okay, great.
Okay, you're in.
Sorry, guys. Okay, now we're in the second part.
Right.
That was intermission.
Right.
So, again, what this is every single office building that's in Fort Lauderdale. So, what generally will take you about 5 seconds to search. This is what's important. We just searched 25 million existing square feet, and it's going to start breaking it down. What's the vacancy? What's the vacancy square footage? What's the availability? Now, CoStar again tracks that shadow sublet market. So you're going to see what's the difference between availability as well as sublet space. So what that basically means is there's a broker, there's a tenant that's informed his owner he's no longer going to be at that space anymore. So they start marketing the space while they're physically there. Okay, so there's, it's important to know what's actually available, what's a vacancy, and what's your availability. So there's a 4% difference there. And then this is the average deal it's taking to do on the market. You know, absorption. And then there's your buildings right there. And then, so again, there's your charts, there's your graphs, and you can blow this up. So, I mean, you can blow it up, and then you dictate the data where you want it to come from. So if you want to see how it's done in the last 5 years, do the last 5 years. If you want to know the last 1 year, do 1 year. It starts showing you. You say, okay, listen, I want to know what's happened all the time in South Florida with Fort Lauderdale. You know, it's going to give you that synopsis too. It's going to print a report out for you so you can do a nice report, and it comes from you, it doesn't come from CoStar. So it's really going to give you a nice synopsis. Again, if you want to do just 1 year, so quarter by quarter, it's going to show you what's been going on in the quarter. If you really are a numbers junkie and you want to know where all these charts and graphs come from, this is where it comes from. I mean, CoStar doesn't just pluck it out of the sky. I mean, it comes from somewhere. So this is the Excel spreadsheet that makes up the charts and graphs. So you can really start looking at these numbers right here and seeing the different numbers of where it came from. So It'll summarize it for you. If you really wanted to, you know, export it, you can export it, see it. It's going to give you a history. So this is the history of the market. I mean, it's going to track it from when we started tracking, you know, office. So this is going to go by the numbers. So it's really going to get deep for you, you know, if you want to track it. If you, you know, if you want to know every single space right now that's on the market, just click this tab right here. This is every single space. There's a thousand spaces. These are all the spaces on the market. Styles has a bunch of spaces in the building that's in downtown. And you can literally start going through it. All the different companies that have spaces on the market.
So the real value here is not knowing the 1,667 properties, but it's defining your submarket or your target. And so when you look at a particular submarket and you say, I want to look at literally just the submarket in downtown Fort Lauderdale, or if you want to look at Wynwood, and, or you want to look at the retail market right in Dania, it gives you the ability to go right to the detail, and you'll find out that there are 20 properties or 10 properties, and all of a sudden you become very smart on the desktop. And after you go to the desktop, you have the ability to print it out, put it in your computer or your hand, and you can drive that market, visit it, and you become as smart as any other real estate professional or broker on the deal.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And once you draw your market, you can go to this tab called Changes, and it's going to tell you velocity. And it's going to tell you exactly what's going on within the market that you define. So whether you want to know, okay, I want to know what's happened in the last year or 6 months, some of the stuff I know, some of the stuff I don't know, it's going to show you sales, space removals, rental rate changes. It's going to show you all the different information. So you become a market expert very fast.
And the most important numbers that are on the screen are not the numbers themselves, but it's the relationship between the numbers.
Yep.
And you'll hear me say that. It's the rate of change between one number and another number. Because a number in isolation doesn't mean anything. The fact that there are 25 million square feet of office properties here doesn't mean anything. But what is important is to know what the number was last year. And if you knew that the number last year was 24 million, then you can say, oh, the office market grew by a million square feet, or 5%. That tells you something, and you can build a story just on that one sentence that I told you, right, folks? Now you can become informed. All right, so now you've told us what the property analytic is, so how is that different from the comps analytic?
So the comps analytics are, if you want to know, okay, I went into my market, call it Fort Lauderdale, call it multifamily, and let's analyze it from the top down. And what's the analytics? So this is, we just use again, our defined market.
So we're gonna put it in Fort Lauderdale again?
Yeah, we'll do Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
All right.
And we'll just use multifamily deals that have been done in the last 2 years.
So wait, how's this different than putting in the office on the comp analytics?
Yeah, sure, so what we did before was we analyzed the market. Now we're analyzing the actual comp statistics. So what this is right here is, this is the top down. So your meeting here.
So let's do office again. Let's keep it consistent.
So here's office.
Just click office for Fort Lauderdale and you're gonna get, I have 706 records.
Yeah, so if I took this date off, it's probably gonna say 706, let's see what it says.
All I do is just Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
So I have 801 now.
It's close.
This is all time. So this is maybe a comp that goes back to 2001. That's probably not relevant. So, or maybe it is relevant, but I would just do the comps for the last 2-3 years.
All right.
And let's keep it relevant of what numbers are gonna pluck out here. So let's do comps. We're gonna analyze 133 comps that have been office done in the last 2 years.
All right.
So if we look at those comps, Now we're going to look at the comps by numbers. The same way we look at the property, but now it's going to show you the comps of transactions. So there's been 133 transactions. And it's going to start showing you all this different data, cap rates. There's your minimum.
This is the activity within the properties.
Yeah.
Which is different than the global information about all the properties. You understand the difference, folks?
Yeah, and what's interesting, what Mark said is, if you want to know the sales volume, this is your sales volume. So that's what happened back in 15. Jumped up. It was a great time to be a broker. Back in 16, you went office, and then here we are right now, year to date. So that's your sales volume. So again, you can build that story.
So there's a lot of information that he said here, and I realize he may not capture this all. And the way to do it is really to have an exercise. Tell us about the star system up in the upper right-hand corner.
So CoStar's got a star system where we have a rating system where a five-star property is the best property out there. It's energy efficient, LEED certified, and it's basically our researchers define the property to make sure that a 4 or 5 star property in Miami is the same as a 4 or 5 star property in, say, you know, Austin, Texas, because in, say, Beverly Hills, those are really nice properties. So we try to keep it the same. We have a white paper right here called buildingratingsystem.com, which will explain to you of how we come up with the building rating system. You can search on the star rating, you can search on A, B, and C, as well. So this is just another component that CoStar has of how we come up with our rating system.
Does this have any relationship to A, B, and C property?
No, it's not a relationship to A, B, C property. It's more relation to a 5-star property, say in a mid-sized city like Austin, Texas, is similar to a 5-star property in New York. It may not be as nice, but it's got the same type of attributes. So, and it explains it to you further. But we let our clients search on A, B, and C anyway. So, is it relevant? I guess it's relevant if you want to make sure your property's a 4-star or 5-star property, but this is just a CoStar rating that we've had for a couple years now.
Great. I have a question about the searching. So you put it in the cities and you put it in counties. Can you put a zip code in there?
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah. So on the right here, I'll show you where it is. On the left hand side rather, you can go. It doesn't matter which module that you're in, but right here on the fourth down, it says zip code. And if you click on it, it'll pop the zip code, and you just put the zip code in right here. So you can search on, and you can search on multiple zip codes simultaneously. So if you wanted to compare a zip code in Hollywood to a zip code in Fort Lauderdale or in West Palm Beach, you can absolutely do that. As long as you move that carrot over right here. And and the most important thing about CoStar is, obviously we do these demonstrations and trainings and workshops, but if you really want to learn how to use CoStar, there's something called the Knowledge Center. And these are videos, PDFs, tutorials, you name it. This is how you really learn how to make money from CoStar. And you'll definitely have some questions about, why we're doing certain things and how, but this is really how you learn how to use a search, because there's alerts that you can search, set in CoStar. There's searches that you can set. So meaning if you have a certain search that you do all the time, you can set that up where it's there and it's called a survey, which you literally just have it set. You go into CoStar, it sends you it'll do the search for you. It also sends you summary emails if there's any changes, meaning we get more information. So there's a lot of cool stuff to learn within the Knowledge Center. And we also have a news section. So this is very cool because it'll show you news of deals getting done, of all different things that are happening. So a lot of our brokers, owners love this. It's press releases when a broker moves, like this particular gentleman, Cushway puts out a press release, His bow tie looks very nice, so, you know, it's a nice thing.
By the way, one thing that I find interesting is that CoStar often holds webinars, which I think are really valuable too, but I don't see it listed right now.
Yeah, so we own webinars. We own a company. It's been rebranded, but we do webinars of all multifamily office, and we store it in here. So webinars would be not the news archive. Maybe it is the news archive. I'll have to find it for you, but they're definitely in here.
Okay.
It's probably in the knowledge center right here. So here's the state of the office market that we're actually doing a webinar in 2 days. You can watch it live. You can register for it. If you don't make it, it'll send you an email, and it'll direct you to where we have it. And you can read all these PDFs all here for you right here. And here's customer support. So if you want to email them, call them, just have that number on you right there.
So where do we go to, how do we sign up for webinars?
Yeah, so right here, go to State of the Office Market,
mm-hmm.
And it goes register now.
And where is that? I'm sorry, go back again.
Yeah, sure.
You're under Knowledge Center?
Yeah, right in Knowledge Center.
Mm-hmm.
And if you click on right here,
but after Knowledge Center, you click on where?
Underneath upstream presentations, in the middle, it'll say State of the Office Market.
So you can register for all of them. Our first one is on the 26th. We basically do these weekly. And then we'll take a couple weeks off, and then they'll do it again, you know, once everything kind of shakes out. But this is obviously our opening webinars for the first quarter. Yeah, sure.
How would you search properties in distress or foreclosure?
You want to know properties that have vacancy issues, right?
The banks are like...
Yeah, that's a great question. So CoStar doesn't track, maybe they will one day, buy a company that tracks foreclosures and things of that nature. But we don't track foreclosures per se. We're tracking the real estate. So the best way to do that is to go into CoStar and track it by vacancy. Now, there are keyword searches that you can do in CoStar that, you know, if the broker does have a for sale for lender, they'll specifically put bank owned or REO. So you can put those keywords in there. And there is a way to do it, if you wanted to see it. So there are keyword searches that you can put in there, but as of right now, it's not specifically searching. Like if we did a for sale search, I'll show you some of the subcategories, because there are ways that you can search. So notice how it has sale condition. So you could search on certain sales that have certain sale conditions. So here's what you were talking about, distress sale.
Yes.
So you could click on that. And if we go show map, so there are 686 that are all real estate that have some sort of distress in it. So you could, and this is where you go, you press additional criteria. And then here's your sale conditions. So this is where I would search it. One very cool thing in CoStar is if you want to know every single property on the market, you could do a search. Now, you gotta keep in mind that sometimes these buildings get pulled up the market too. So you really gotta do your due diligence and call these brokers to make sure they're really for sale, because there are some owners out there, some brokers that unfortunately just take orders and take listings, and it's not real. We'll put it up there, because we, you know, that's what you have to be reported. There's all different cool things to do, days in the market, properties that have been on the market for a certain period of time. There's a way to look at when deals were bought at a certain period of time with down payments. This is a huge one when there was a condo conversion era, when buyers were putting down 10%, 50%. So you can go back in time. So there's some very cool things here that you could search on. So this is how you would find some distress situation or some owner that just needs to get out of his property. You know, and a lot of times you uncover it, maybe they're about to go back to the bank and you get in touch with the bank and you become the new listing broker for the bank or vis-a-vis short sale. Maybe they do a deed in lieu. A lot of stuff goes on, as Mark knows. There's buyers buying notes, you know, and so a lot of things are going on. But this is good because it lets you know what's going on and you're in the know. This, you know, and one last thing, if you ever want to look up a property, a owner name, a person's name, I call this the Google Bar CoStar. Just, you know, go right here, you know, plug it in, and it'll find it. So whether it's an address, person's name, it's right here. It's called the lookup bar. So I like going to all properties, just because that's why I like doing it, but you can do it this way too. Search by property, search by comp, tenant, real estate professional, all different ways. So hopefully you guys learned something today.
What other questions do you have? You got the expert in front of you here.
There's an overlap between the market aspect of LoopNet and CoStar. What can a broker ignore LoopNet entirely and just use CoStar as a listing tool as well?
It's a great question.
I saw the other day you can add your property to it.
Yep. So it's a great question. So the value of LoopNet is if you're a listing broker, you want to have your listings on LoopNet because the statistics that LoopNet has run, and they did a study with Google about a year and a half ago that, you know, we all go on the website if we want to book a hotel room or whatnot, banking, things of that nature, that 89% of the people, 95% of the people go on the internet before they buy a car, things of that nature. So if you're a broker that has listings, and it's a real listing, that's not some you know, a dog, you know, it's a real listing, you want to have it on LoopNet because 75% of the LoopNet audience that search LoopNet, they go through Google, Yahoo, Bing, they type in for sale, Florida, Florida, and that's how you're going to find, or they go directly to LoopNet.
But for the sake of data direction, stuff flows from LoopNet to CoStar, but it doesn't go from CoStar to LoopNet
no.
in the same way, right?
No. Nothing of CoStar goes into LoopNet. That's why CoStar is called a professional tool and LoopNet is called the marketing service. Because your general investor that owns property, they're not going to be a CoStar subscriber. They're going to be probably a LoopNet basic member. They're going to log into LoopNet and they're going to search for listings that are for sale. The only listings they see are paid listings. So, you know, what happens is a lot of brokers put listings on LoopNet. They're basic listings. They're invisible. Nobody sees them. So it's like going to Craigslist, putting the listing up there, and it says, not visible. You know, and so you're paying to be a premium lister. So yeah, if you're a broker and you have listings, you absolutely want premium lister.
So what's the cost today for LoopNet and CoStar separately?
Yeah, sure. So it's all based on geography. LoopNet has all different plans. There's the one cool thing about LoopNet is LoopNet gives you the flexibility of doing an individual plan, meaning it's your plan. or if you had a company that's big enough and they want to take on the expense and there's enough listing brokers there, they could do a company listing plan. And the benefit of that is your price per listing goes down. But some brokers don't want that because they want their own plan and they want it to go with them wherever they are. CoStar, it's all based on geography and it's all based on the company that you work at.
Can I ask another question?
Yeah.
So do you see a lot of incidents out there where the sales agents themselves are buying subscription, or is it mostly the brokers?
Well, CoStar only licenses companies.
Okay.
They don't license individuals.
Okay.
So if there's a broker that works for a company and they decide to open up their own shop, or they go on and they say, you know what, it's time for me to move on because I've generated enough business and I'm gonna go open up a partnership. It happens all the time. I get calls all the time from brokers that are working at shops that are very productive, saying, Daryl, I'm thinking about moving, or I'm thinking about opening up my own shop. What's CoStar gonna cost me? And LoopNet as well, because I have listings. So we put together a bundle package for them. It's very common. It's very common that we have that. I think what's happened with LoopNet, which a lot of people, old school people, have a tough time dealing with, even myself when I first went to CoStar, for years LoopNet offered what they call LoopNet Lister and Searcher as one package. And about 2 years ago, has nothing to do with me, they separated, the LoopNet corporate separated out Lister and Searcher. Now everyone's got their own opinions about it, or the CoStar got involved, whatever, it doesn't really matter. That's the way they offer it. So Lister is one package, and they do offer Searcher, but everything on LoopNet goes into CoStar anyway. So it's something we'll give to a person, but they don't really need it, because CoStar is a professional tool. It's gonna have all the listings. That's one last thing I should show you guys. There is a filter that's in CoStar that'll show you listings that are not in LoopNet. Now, again, there are a lot of people that like the LoopNet interface. They just like it. It's nice to use. So we'll give you both tools. So you can go in here and see listings not visible to LoopNet Basic members, LoopNet Premium members. And this is important because, again, this goes back to where we are, you know, in the world today. Investors are very smart people, obviously. You know, some may not be smart, but they're smart people. They're gonna go on the internet and, you know, they can if they can buy a $10 million property, they can pay LoopNet X amount of money. So you want to always know more than them. You know what's going on. So if you know they're a premium member, you do not want to show them deals that they can see themselves. You know, unless it's your deal, of course. You know, so that makes sense to you. I have my own unique perspective because I used to be a broker, and I learned the hard lesson when I first started as a green broker to never go on LoopNet and show a deal that your own client can see. And luckily that client taught me the business. He's a very active, you know, investor. So that's a lot of times how you run the business. You're basically directly from the clients.
Does everybody understand what he's talking about? Don't be shy. Do you get it? I just want to make sure people realize.
I have another good question. Can I pull out an actual operating income spreadsheet out of data from any given building? I know I can get rentals.
Yeah.
Can I get
my due diligence information?
Yeah.
No, that's not something we have. I mean, obviously the broker provides it and puts in a little NOI and things of that nature. We're gonna put it out there. But the truth of the matter is, we can put all that stuff in there. You gotta get all that stuff by yourself. Meaning you put the deal on the contract and get the due diligence packet, do the estoppels, and because you as the investor, if that's how you're operating, or even the buyer's broker, you're gonna do your own analysis anyway. You know, I mean, again, where I used to work, Marcus Millichap, we have these fancy, packages, and it's all fluff and puff and stuff like that. Really, what the investor wants to see is a two-page executive summary. What's the deal? What's the rents? What's the NOI? And depending on what type of buyer they are, where can they push the deal? Or from what cap rate? So, CoStar is your, you know, it's a necessity for you to know more than the person you're speaking to, because I always tell myself this, I'm always going to be a broker, whether I work at CoStar for the rest of my life or not. You never want to get on the phone and know less than them. You always want to know more than them. As much as we like to tell ourselves, and Mark knows this, that all buyers are you're loyal, they're not loyal. Nobody's loyal. And that's fine. You know, there are going to be a lot of brokers, a lot of investors that are loyal to you as a selling broker because they know that you command a higher price because of your process. But as far as buying deals, very few and far between. A lot of times you want to deal directly with a listing agent because they know the roadmap to the deal easier, if that makes sense to you guys. They know what's going on with the seller's head. You know, then now if you happen to have a great relationship with the selling broker and you've done deals with them, it's a different story. Now, I did a lot of buy-side deals when I was a broker, but part of my strategy sometimes, believe it or not, was to throw a bone to the listing broker and give him part of my buy-side fee so that he would really tell me the true story, because then I would lose that buyer, you know? And so it was more important for me to perform so I would get repeat business from him. And he was said loyalty. So it's one of those things where you really got to read between the lines a lot of times. And trust me, I could go on with you guys till midnight about deals I got burned on, and that's why I lost a lot of hair, you know.
Is that what's happening?
Okay. No, I'm just talking.
All right, let's give Garrow a round of applause.
Thank you for your time.
Very definitely.
Garrow, where can I get your card again?
Yeah, sure. I'll order it if you want it right now.
I have a quick question.
Yeah, sure.
In terms of market data, is it only for the United States for the service?
So we have market data. We track. That's another great question. CoStar is in Toronto. It's basically all major cities in Canada. So we have market data there. We also are in Europe as well as the UK. We recently acquired a company in Spain, and we recently acquired another company in Germany as well. So a lot of those companies are now getting rebranded because they have their own names, and they it's a different language. So there's back end technology, a lot of that stuff, but it's worldwide. I mean, I'm actually originally from South Africa, so if they can ever go there, I'll go there, you know, and work there. So, but it's tough because a lot of countries don't have any data, which is actually an opportunity for CoStar. There are a lot of states, and Florida's not one of them, where CoStar is even more valuable, like Texas. It's a non-disclosure state, so it doesn't, like, transactions don't have to be, doesn't go in, like, profit got bought for $50 million. And CoStar tracks down that information, which makes it even more valuable to an owner, investor, broker that they have that data. So important for single tenant too. You know, so to know what, because there's a lot of markets in the country that are more single tenant driven, like Texas, things of that nature, Louisiana, those type of states. So you definitely want to know what the cap rates are trading for, and things of that nature. So.
Okay, great comments.
Yes, sir. Thank you. You guys, my cards are not.
All right, why don't we take a little break while I set myself up here for about 10 minutes, and then we'll get ourselves into the next phase of our class. All right? open the doors. Let's get some air in here somehow. Maybe turn off the air conditioning.
I will. I'll email Mark all my information.
Yeah, that's right. I'll send it to everybody. Folks.
And the forward all to you guys.
I see you here on the.
Oh, you see my picture? Send me. Yeah, actually, I'm probably on your little picture right there. And if you want to email me, but I'll email it to Mark. And if you guys want to email me, call me.
Yeah, I'd like to ask a question.
Yeah, absolutely. Tell you what. Send you an email if you want to write down your information on here. Work too hard, man. That's insane.
Is anything your site free?
Yeah, well, yeah, so you can log on to LoopNet and log on as a free member. So you can see some information on LoopNet as a basic member. So if you go on LoopNet, it's probably going to ask for your name, email address, phone number, things. And you can search LoopNet.
You have to register, okay.
Yeah.
Just thinking from the library perspective, would it be something that we would want to add to the, definitely add it into a guide for real estate, but we would want to include it on almost a daily basis?
Yeah, we can, I mean, you let us know. We're very, very big into education with the university. And I know we've been working with NOVA, FIU, UM for a very long time. So, I mean, CoStar is very big in the tools and different classes that, use our service.
And as a library, we're joint use with Broward County. So that's why I wanted to see if there was something.
Well, yeah, Broward County is one of ours.
But thanks to the students, we're not offering that.
Oh, no, yeah, sure, yeah.
That's why I think it's for that.
Yeah. Yeah, we have all different partnerships with all the different universities and things of that nature. But obviously, NOVA's number one,
Okay.
So.
There you go.
Thanks for your time, guys.
Thank you.
All right, Mark, I'll let you get back to work. Yeah, sure.
What's the average subscription fee?
Yeah, sure. Call me.
there's no standard.
You're ready to pay him, I can tell that.
Here, call me.
Hey, do you know a guy by the name of Adam Vaughn?
Sure, Adam Vaughn Romer. Yeah.
He said you guys are giving out for his students.
Where does he work? No, he's been, I don't know, actually, I think I met Adam a long time ago, but he's actually very good friends of mine.